Hey dolls, it's your girl Tiffany coming to you today with another makeup tutorial. Today I'm going to be doing a Christmas inspired makeup tutorial, and I want to wish you guys a very, very merry, merry Christmas on this holiday season. I also have a little bit of a cold, so if I sound a little nasally throughout the voiceover, I apologize. But if you care to see how I did this very glam red and green eyeshadow look with the glitter lip, then please keep watching. And again, Merry Christmas.
Hey dolls, so I primed my lids with my concealer. I'm now going to go in with the Makeup Geek and MannyMUA palette using the color Peach in the Smoothie and applying this to my highlight area. Then I'm going to go in with the color Sora and apply that right underneath that Peach in the Smoothie color using the same blending brush. Then going in with the color Frappe and applying that right under the Sora color to get a smooth transition color. Next, I'll be going in to the color Mars. Now I am using my concealer with a small angle brush and just carving out my cut crease. And I'm doing a very subtle cut crease. I'm only applying it on my mobile lid, not extending it over my mobile lid. And after I do this, I'm going to then go in to the color Luna and apply this right over where I put that concealer using a small eyeshadow brush, using a patting motion to make sure that I get the color intensity that I would like. After I do that, I'm going to then go in with the NYX color in hot red with a small tapered pencil brush and then going right over where that Luna color is meeting and where that Mars color is meeting. Then I'm going to blow that out with a small tapered gold hair brush from Morphe Cosmetics. I will have this detailed list of the brushes that I'm using in the description box. Next, I'm going to go in with the Inglot gel liner, and I'm going to be using the colors 77 and also the color 79. I've already did the wing. Now what you see me doing here is going in with that color 79, which is a very pretty red, with a disposable eyeliner brush, and going into the inner one third of my eye to connect that wing. I'm really just making it very nice and neat and taking my time doing this, and then really blending that red into that black to give it an ombre effect with my eyeliner. After doing that, I'm going to then go in with the color Mousse and Ignite with a smudger brush and smudge my waterline and really diffuse those two colors really, really pretty for that waterline area. After I do that, I'm going to then take some powder on my beauty blender, which is from Morphe, and just really clean up that under waterline area. Next, I'm going to take my Morphe Cosmetics concealer in the color Frappe and apply this to my blemishes, which are on my contour areas, and then blending that out. And I absolutely love, love, love this concealer. It is absolutely amazing. It's only $5. It's the best ever. Next, I'm going to take my Hourglass Vanish Stick Foundation in the color Warm Almond and just applying stripes all over my face in no particular order, and then I'm going to blend that out with my Morphe beauty sponge. Now, I am starting to really, really enjoy this Morphe Beauty Sponge. It, in comparison to the Beauty Blender, it's running a pretty, it's pretty neck and neck for me with the Morphe Sponge as well as the Beauty Blender. And it works just as well as the Beauty Blender, in my opinion. It's just as soft, just as buoyant. So what you see me doing here is just really blending that into my skin. I also wanted to talk about this foundation. This foundation is absolutely amazing. It really, really just melts into your skin and gives you a very skin-like finish. Although the color intensity on this foundation is amazing. You don't need a lot. And that's another thing that I love about wearing having sticky foundations as opposed to doing liquids is you don't tend to overuse the product. So I really, really love this Hourglass stick foundation, and it really just it gives you such a natural, pretty skin-like finish. You don't really even look like you have on makeup, which I absolutely love about this foundation. And as you see me here, I'm just really working it in with my Morphe Beauty Sponge and taking my time in doing that. I'm going to take my my Sasha Buttercup powder and Allure Mercier powder mixed and set my under eye area with that. And after I do that, I'm going to then blend that out with a Morphe. I think this is the dome blending brush. I'm not sure. I will put a description of all the brushes I use in the description box. Then going back in with that Morphe concealer in the color Frappe and just concealing the darker circles that I may have in the inner one-third part of my eye. And then you want to also make sure that you set that as well. And I'm going to be setting that using my all-over powder, which is my MAC Mineralized Skin Finish in the color Dark Tan. And I'm just applying this all over my face and then using that as well to set that concealer that I just laid down in the inner one-third of my eye to help conceal my under eye circles. Next, I'm going to be going in with that hot red color again, which is a blush, actually. But hello, you can use blush and use it as a eyeshadow as well. Just saying. It's powder. Powder is powder. But I'm going to apply this to the apples of my cheeks and then blending that out with an angled brush. Then I'm going to be going in with the NYX Illuminating Stick in the color Bermuda Bronze and applying this to my highlight areas and then blending that out with my finger. I'm using my phalanges, as she would say, because they're warm, and this is a cream product and it blends in a little bit better for me. So I use my phalanges, and then after I do that, I'm going to go over that with the Becca and Jaclyn Hill collab using the Champagne Pop and to intensify that highlight area. Get the highlight gotta be popping. Next, I'm going to be going in with the Dose of Colors Burning Red lip gloss and using this as my base for my glitter. I absolutely love glitter, if you did not know that already. But if you've been watching me for a long time, you know that I'm a glitter girl. I'm a little obsessed with glitter. But now you see me going in with the Urban Decay lip liner, and I believe it's called Night Moth. I will put the color in the description box to be sure, but I believe it's Night Moth. I'm lining my lips with that. Now this is the beautiful glitter. This is from LA Splash Cosmetics, and this is in the color Starlight Red, and I am applying this with my finger and just using patting motions and really patting that into that Burning Love color from Dose of Colors. And making sure that I take my time and really pressing that into my base red color so that I don't get fallout. That's the key. And that I'm making it very neat, because red is also a very hard color to use, period. And then if you're using red with red glitter, it makes it even harder. So just make sure that you take your time to do this step. Next, I'm going in with a mini beauty blender and taking whatever residue I have from my concealer that's on my sponge and just cleaning up that my lip line area to make sure that it doesn't look like there's any bleed out or anything like that, and making sure that it looks very, very nice and very polished. And that is it, guys. Hope that you enjoyed this video. I want you guys to have a very, very happy, happy holidays. Until next time, guys, deuces. Oh, and please make sure that you like, comment, and subscribe.